Greetings. I'm Anthony F. Elmore, president and founder of the Proud Black Buddhist World Association. We at the Proud Black Buddhist World Association are not only the Black Buddhist force in America, but we are the Black Buddhist force in the world. And today, we bring you one of our most exciting and most important Buddhist lectures. My lecture today is called Black Buddhist History, the Indus Valley Civilization. We Black people only know and talk about our history in Africa. We have a civilization that's 3,000 years older than the Egyptian civilization and twice as large as Mesopotamia and Egypt put together, the Indus Valley Civilization, our Black Buddhist history. Buddhist history is Black history. When you learn your Black Buddhist history, you will learn the Black Buddhist connection to Christian history. Now, let's kind of get into a little history. And I want you to Google some words. Now, the first word I want you to Google, I want you to Google a river. Now, this river is called the Sarawati River. Now, this river dried up about 4,000 years ago. From this river emerged a Black people in a culture twice as large as Egypt and Mesopotamia combined. These Black people along the Sarawati River built a city so complex that the world had to wait 2,000 more years to the rise of the Roman civilization for sanitation and town planning to reach a comparable level. You see, what white people often teach is that Black people grew up uneducated, uncivilized, and they didn't become civilized until white people came on the scene. But when you study the Sarawati River culture, you will learn that Africans or Black people had a civilization with running bathroom, running water, toilets, a sewer system, dynamic urban planning, 2,000 years before white people even had such things. This civilization of the Sarawati River is also known as the Harappan culture. Now, these are two names for the civilization. It's called the Indus Valley, and it's commonly known as the Harappan civilization. This is what white races try hard to prove. White races attempt to use history to support white superiority and the inferiority of Black people. When you have evidence of Blacks who were scientific, cultural, and far advanced in science thousands of years before whites, there is silence. The Kushites developed civilizations all around the world. In fact, in Japan, they were called the Ainu. Now, what we call India today was known at the time of the Afro-Greek writer Homer, India was known as Eastern Ethiopia. And the Kushites along the Sarawati River created the largest city and city planning that was 2,000 years before any people known as white people had ever had city planning. They created a complex or a city that was, or a civilization that was twice as large as Egypt and Mesopotamia put together. Now, what happened was this. It was not only the Buddha who was black. The black Buddhists would spread their religion around the world. White people called Greeks would adopt the Buddhist religion. These black Buddhists left India and moved to Africa, and they were called Israelis. We know these Jews, and they had a name, and they were called the tribe of Judah. See, these black Buddhists were called many names. They conquered Egypt, and they were called the Hyksos, or the Shepherd Kings. You can see these black Buddhists in Egypt with the snake. The snake was called a Naga, and these Buddhists were called Nagas in India, but in Africa they were called Nubians. And we know about the Nubians, and the Nubians were Buddhists because the father of history, Herodotus, wrote about the Buddhists. They were not called Buddhists, they were called Gymnosophists. Gym means naked, sophists means philosophers, and Herodotus visited Nero, which was the capital, and it was Herodotus who said that Nero was the cradle of the Gymnosophists. Also, I want you to look at a Buddhist temple in Africa, in Egypt. It's called the Apademak Temple. What you see in the Apademak Temple, you see the Naga snake coming out of the lotus flower, and you see the Buddha head. See, Buddha was known as the sage of the chakras, or the lion of the chakras. Now, these black Buddhists were founders of what we know today as Rome. Now, look this up. The original Romans were called Etruscans. The Etruscans and the people of India they called Dravidians were one and the same people. They were also known by another name, and that is they were known as the Sumerians. So when you look in the Bible and you read about the Good Samaritan, the Samaritans, the Etruscans, the Gymnosophists, Buddhists had many different names, but we know that they were Buddhists. In fact, there was another group of Buddhists. They were called the Krishnas, and the Krishnas spread their Buddhist religion all over Europe, and the white people took the Buddha in his mother. They were called Madonnas. Ask any white person or any religious person why you have black Madonnas. You have black Madonnas because that is the story of the Buddha and his mother. The baby Buddha's mother were the Madonnas. And this eventually became known as the religion of Christianity. I am Anthony L. Elmore, president and founder of the Proud Black Buddhist World Association, bringing to you a new and exciting Buddhist lecture.
All ancient icons show a simple fact. They all show that the Buddha was black. I believe in facts and the Cato was wrong. Buddha was no Aryan. This song saw the history by those who read.